Whatever, over here.
Okay.
You're right. I know the way that the fight played out, but do you, is this the end, or do you feel that you would want to write what was wrong tonight?
Listen, I'm going to say it one last time. I'm really serious about this because as my team, not only personal team, but my team recording board, I can also say my family with HBO, all the HBO people that's backing me, behind me, and support me. Win, lose, I mean, y'all don't believe most fighters in our team should, but trust me, if it would have been the other way around, with no, if you want to call this a misfortune, that's what I call it, or a controversy, whatever. Win, lose, Bernard, Dan Raphael. I told y'all both the same thing, you know y'all didn't ask the question, but I told the main writers in boxing, Ron Burgess, I mean, when you talk about those three names, win, lose, or draw, or controversy. I said that, y'all. And that's it. I mean, y'all can keep asking me, I'm not even, you know, trust me, I'll be telling the same thing, but I think time is going to really say it all, because I'll be 52 in a couple of weeks, in January 15th. Then I'll be 53, God willing. And if anyone y'all still around, I'm 60, y'all gonna ask me if I'm gonna do one more, then that's on y'all. Because I still look like I probably can. But I'm not. And this is the fight that I wanted. A meaningful fight. Not a cherry pick. And that's why the fans love me. That's why I love the fans. Whether the East Coast, West Coast, Midwest, South, doesn't matter. I take on the baddest and biggest in my era. And my era was going 2 eras ago, remind me. So, I have no regrets. I have no regrets. Because my team, not only Oscar De La Hoya, go to both promotions, and also HBO, Peter Nelson, and all the guys, they backed me because they knew I wanted this fight. And my last and final one. And so, however it ended, I ended with a conversation. Unfortunately, it didn't go the way I wanted to go. But who would think I'd give y'all something to talk about at the end of the year to go into 2017?
Zach.
Whatever y'all think is about. But I tell you, I felt good. I felt that like most fights that I fought, I come on at the time where I figure the puzzle out, and then I execute. Any more questions?
Bernard, you said that this was the round I was going to make something happen of the 8th round. What was your plan of attack, you know, for the fight's remaining rounds?
Thank you. Back to the body. I was hitting some good body shots, and I heard him respond to those good body shots. And he was missing. He was missing with most of his punches. And frustrated. And I just seen him getting frustrated. And I just wanted to hang in there, weather the storm. If you can take it, you can make it. And that's all I kept saying in my mind. If you can take it, you can make it, because we based everything on a power punch. And I knew I could take a good punch. As you see tonight, I knew I could take a good punch. Now, can you take accumulation of punches where I know if I take them in deep water, then I know I'd be able to go ahead and slow the big giant down, and he starts slowing down around the 6th and the 7th, when I was cutting through the body shots and throwing my combinations, and I was getting my rhythm. I noticed that he was slowing down. I noticed the punches wasn't effective as he was the first 3 or 4 rounds. Any more?
yeah, let me do something real quick.
Well, I didn't know it was all over. I didn't know that if I wanted to get back just knew that I was going to get some time or be able to walk on it. And the commission did ask me when I went back in the ring. And I said, yeah. And he said, can you stand on it? And I said, I feel it, but I stand on this throbbing. And he said, well, I don't want you to go back in there. And that's when they said he came back in the ring. And I know how I feel when you either twist your ankle or you tweak it. So